Hello everybody and welcome to a new let's play of a game that is called Gutwale. So Gutwale was just released on Steam a few days ago. It's an indie game and I heard that it's only been developed by free software developers within a month. So as far as I understand it, the story goes, they were sitting in a quarantine and something for a month and didn't know what to do, and they came up with this amazing game. So what's it? What is this game? It's a roguelike. Or a roguelite, like they call it. It's basically a procedurally generated game, and each run is slightly different, and you are playing this middle-aged man on the screen, and you are inside the guts of a whale. Yes, that is exactly what's going on. And yeah, and what are you gonna do? You have a shotgun and you have one bullet, and for some reason you can reuse that bullet if you catch it. And that's it, you have only that one bullet and you need to survive the guts of the whale. And everything will kill you in one hit. So you need to be very, very careful. And very strange things are happening on the screen. So I'm seeing the same thing that you are seeing, you know? So there is... This game is very weird and it does make zero sense, I think. So right now I'm just running around and I'm demonstrating you the basic gameplay. It's very, very strange and I don't have really words to describe this. And unfortunately, I don't really understand yet how it exactly works. So yeah, each time you die, a huge van falls out from the sky for some reason. So yeah, the game does make sense. That is definitely its selling point. No, the game does make no sense whatsoever. I think that is the point of the game, you know? It's just very weird and... Yeah, and what I don't yet understand yet is why am I dying sometimes with a hit and sometimes I can respawn? I think it has something to do with the hearts to my left. The game didn't really explain that to me, I think. But yeah, we have one heart right now, so that would mean that we will die with one hit. Like now, we died. That's not a good thing is, each time we die, this amazing van falls down and gives us basically revenge. Every enemy in the room is dead after the thing falls. And yeah, that gives some sort of satisfaction at least, if you died for reasons you not necessarily agree with. The game can be very punishing and very ruthless, so yeah. I'm not optimal at playing this game, but I reached in my test run, I think, stage 4. So yeah, the game has stages. A moment ago we reached stage 2, I think. And yeah, what you're seeing right now is what the game is all about, so... yes, you will die like every 10 seconds. I mean, I die like every 10 seconds. Maybe you will be much more better than me at this, but the way I play it, I just died the whole time and restart. And to be completely honest, the first time I played this game, I went like completely crazy. Unfortunately, I didn't record that, but it's... I don't even know how to describe it. The game is just so weird, it messes with my head. So I won't be able to play it on a long session, I think. Yeah, I'm really curious what was the idea behind this game. Probably there's some forum on Steam, some thread that explained this, because there must be a story behind it. Let's just look at this. There must be something. Something must have happened to the developers that caused this monstrosity to being developed. Yeah, and this frog, I have no idea what it is, but each time we shoot at it, we decrease this number, and I think something amazing will happen when we reached... when we reach zero. So now, each time we finish a stage, we can buy something. And I'm gonna buy a heart, I think. That sounds amazing too. Maybe we should go with that. Oh, this thing will give us 3 hearts, am I correct? So right now we bought another head and we got 4 hearts, so we can get hit, I think, 3 times before we die. That is very useful. Oh, and that enemy takes 2 hits. That is new to me. This is interesting. So we need to be extra careful around him. So yeah, this is basically the second stage right now. And yeah. Okay, definitely. So the hearts are our lives. So it's not actually a hit point, it's a life. That's good to know. Now, we can keep the bullets. when they die, at least as long as we have health bar left. Okay, now we lost all our bullets and we lost all our heads. Or the head, I mean. Yeah, and I apologize in advance. I have issues commentating this game because I, as already said, this game makes me crazy in my head somehow. It's even more difficult to formulate coherent sentences than it is without. And I don't know why. I don't know. I mean, I have some ideas why. Just look at this. Look at the screen. But yeah, that is a very, very strange game. And I've never played games like this before, so that is especially strange for me. So yeah, Gut Whale. So if we look around, we can see there is a building, and we are descending this building floor by floor. And we are at the same time inside the guts of a whale, supposedly. Now, I'm not actually sure, is this actually a whale? Maybe this is all a dream of his and it's actually not a whale. Maybe it's some sort of eldritch abomination. I don't know. But that is obviously not a healthy whale, because just look at this. If you have a jellyfish inside your guts, then this totally has something wrong with you, and your whale should see the veterinarian, you know. Guts should not exist within... I mean, yeah, difficulty to produce coherent sentences. Yeah, so if you have jellyfish and skulls inside your guts, then you have some serious issues. Okay, that things. I don't know how to do them. So I think the big skull here is a clear pattern, but this thing, it just targets us. Now let's go. Oh, okay. So his pattern, I think the key here is the priority. We need to prioritize dangerous enemies that can kill us and kill the others later. Because unfortunately we have only one shot, and okay, that is good. So now we can use all the bullets that we collected and decrease the counter. Now we are by 40 on 43, I think. So 43, I have no idea what happens when we reach... oh, that is nice, but we can't afford that. What is this? I think this will give us points. Let's try that out. So yeah, what was it? Wait a moment. Did we actually reach stage level 3? We did. I didn't even notice. Wow. So yeah, this is what happens frequently in this game, for me at least. I just played and then suddenly I'm in stage 4 or 3 and I just, what the hell is going on? How did I get here? What am I doing here? And yeah, that is very, very interesting. So now I think we are still in stage 1, but I have this tunnel vision right now. I have no idea where I really am or what is going on. But there's something I heard. So if you kill an enemy from above and then catch the bullet in the air, then you get some sort of bonus. You get points, and these points are essential. Like now, I think I got something for that reward. So these points are important to buy stuff like lives or health or whatever. So we need to kill the enemies in a satisfying way. And by the way, did you notice each time the enemy is defeated, his corpse flies around in the background? Oh, that was a good hit from his part. Okay, so this tiny whale, I'm gonna call him Wally. He is eating his own father. That is certainly very parasitic. I just noticed that he's actually eating the guts. Just look at that. He is eating his host. So what is he? What sort of fish is that? Because the whale is gonna die. Maybe we are the immune system. Maybe we are the chosen one to free the whale from his misery, you know? That would be such an interesting spin. Now I think that thing can kill us if we go too near. Okay, so I don't know if we are truly the immune system. What is that? Bullet bowler. I have no idea what that is. I want to know what that is. That gave us 3 lives. That is interesting. So very, very good deal in my opinion. Let's deal with that. No, he dealt with us, unfortunately. Now he is out of the equation. Oh no. So now we are down to only 1 life again, but the enemy is quite weak now. I think we can get them in sync. No, we can't. That's unfortunate. So we are in the first stage again, and so my strategy is just deal with the jellyfish on the first stage. There's the biggest danger. And I think each stage, now that I think about it, each stage has this priority. So the first stage is a jellyfish. The jellyfish needs to go. It's the first one. The second stage has, I think, this flying ninja star thing. That needs to go, because otherwise you're dead. So the third stage, I'm not sure what this third stage is actually about. I think, this ninja star, it is the biggest danger here. So this is priority number one. Deal with that. The others are just, they're just basically nothing. So 2 ninja stars, bad start. But are they out of bullets? I think they are. No, we weren't. That's sad. That's a shame. Anyway, so after the ninja star, we would have reached the, I think, the third level. And I'm not sure what the third stage is all about. But I think there's some sort of strange animal that looks suspiciously like some sort of silkworm. So yeah, the whale is definitely in some serious health conditions right now. And you see this exclamation marks? They mean that there are enemy below us. So we should not be standing there. Please go away. So we should not be standing above an exclamation mark. Now, we are about to reach the next stage. Is what I wanted to say. But we died. That's so unfortunate. Now, I think sometimes it's important in this game not to jump, because some enemies can anticipate your jumps, or maybe... I'm not sure if they're that intelligent, but I think sometimes jumping is what killed me. So, let's be careful. Sometimes just running is better than jumping. Like, right now, how do we even deal with that? Jellyfish. Jellyfish goes first, then everything else. Now, frog. Please, frog. 40. So we need to get 40 hit points. I'm not sure why are we getting so much points. That is new to me. Maybe I just improved my gameplay. But in my previous experiences, the points were very, very hard to come by. So I'm a bit surprised that we are doing so nice points-wise. Wow. Wow. You see what I mean? Sometimes jumping is what kills you. That is... okay. The ninja star must go first. Ah, oh, that's so sad. The ninja star, okay, it went. Now deal with this flower thing. Now these things are surprisingly easy to get in sync. If you get them in sync, it's basically over for them. There's nothing they can do. Let's collect all the bullets to the left side so we can deal with the frog. No, he takes 2 hits. I forgot about that. Such a waste of perfect bullets. That was a waste of a completely great life. Okay, I really think we are playing some sort of immune system. I mean, I don't know, how is life as the immune system? You know, maybe that is exactly how it is like. Maybe the immune system thinks that it looks like a human. I don't know, it doesn't have a mirror or anything. I mean, how does this guy even know how he looks if there are no mirrors around, you know? I don't know. But anyway, we are inside this guard, and our goal is to escape, I think. I think that was set in the tutorial, but I'm not sure yet. Maybe there was no goal. Maybe this game is infinite. Who knows? Maybe it is literally procedurally generated, and it will never come to an end, and we're just trapped in this limbo forever. I hope not. But we are on 39. The frog is now 39 points. So I'm really, really curious what's gonna happen when we actually defeat it or whatever. So yeah, that was another stupid hit. What's going on? Are we attracting the bullets or something? Wow, wait a moment, what? Look at that! We are attracting the bullets! See, they are coming to... Oh, aren't they? Yeah, they're coming. Am I stupid? Was it always like this, or is it the effect of the head? You see, they are attracted back at us. Now that is amazing. That means we can execute amazing jumps. Do you see that? Oh, wow. I didn't see the mushroom. That's so stupid. Now, deal with them one at a time. And collect... how many... Do we have a hit? No, we don't have a hit. We don't have a bullet. Now, somehow I just killed 2 with 1 bullet. I don't know how that worked. Sometimes it works. Sometimes you can hit actually 2 enemies with 1 bullet, but I'm not sure what the mechanic behind that is. Maybe it needs to be a perfect hit or something, I don't know. Now, 38. Something tells me we won't defeat the frog in this episode, but I remain optimistic. Okay. Now, the flower. Oh, that was double kill, basically. So she, the thing killed me and I killed it. That is the first time it happened to me. Okay, please. By the way, I'm playing this game with a keyboard. I tried to play it with controllers. It has built-in support for controllers, but for some reason, I can't do that. For some reason, it's so weird that I just... It's not for me. Each time I try to use my Xbox controller, I just die the whole time. I don't know why. I think it's just not precise enough. So the game is not in early access, correct me if I'm wrong. The game is already finished, or supposedly it's finished. But the game designers, the game developers are still responding to feedback and even changing mechanics of the game. So in a way, it's still in development, I think. So don't quote me on that. And it is right now on a sale on Steam. It costs only £3, 59 pence, if I'm correct. And it is down to 10% right now. So after the sale, it will slightly go up, but it's very cheap. and it's definitely worth the money in my opinion. Just look at it, look at everything that's going on. It's really, really addictive, that I can assure you. And there's more to it. There's much more. I'm just scraping on the surface right now. And I'm gonna show you something amazing. Let's go back and let's go into auctions and let's actually do this. Let's turn the bulge on. Now, what is the bulge? The bulge is amazing. While we let's start just with the bulge. That should be enough. So now basically everything hits the fan. Look at this. This nice effect will make you crazy over time. I won't spend too much in it because this is what messed up with my head last time. It's really, really it's really weird, and I don't know. I literally felt dizzy after that. So be careful with that effect. It's not a nice gimmick, but it is something, and it's certainly, if you're okay with that, if you're into that thing, then it will provide you with some sort of fun. Now, I don't know what to think about that. Something tells me that this was how the game initially looked, and then the developers changed strategy and made it humanly usable. Okay, so maybe we should disable. Yeah, I'm playing very poorly with that effect on, and maybe we should disable that. I don't like it. Okay, let's go back and disable the bulge. Oh, no, not extreme bulge. Please no. And now feedback. What is feedback? Let's test feedback. Feedback is something I absolutely hate. It is this. Maybe you can't see it, but each time I press a button, the screen shakes. That is so terrible, I can't find words for it. This is the worst. This messes up. This is messes me up completely. Just look at it. It's so weird, and wow. I can't even find words to describe it anymore, and yeah. Okay, I just pressed escape because I want to escape this hell. Okay, so I won't be playing with this effect on for too long, but just to showcase it to you guys, I will leave it on for a while and show you how it operates. So yeah, terrible. okay, that is... Maybe you should buy this game and experience it for yourself, because nothing that I do right now can pay justice. It is so, so terrible. this is just, it's hard to describe. So everything shakes and it is like, I don't even know, it's like literal hell. Okay, let's just restart this, honestly. Let's remove this effect and please, no feedback. I don't like feedback. There's also another music, but it's nothing to be proud of. It's just a whistle, and yeah, it's what it is. So okay, let's try another hat. Let's try. Actually, you can change hats here. So this gives more points for some reason. And this one, where's the other hat? Strong calves. Give me strong calves. Where is it? Here. You can run. I think you can run faster with it, and I like it. Running faster is certainly a good thing. But if you get used to it, it can be bad, because then you will expect every time to get easily away, and it will mess with you when you get another head, I think. So okay, let's deal with this nonsense here. The jellyfish are not that dangerous once you know their pattern, they're just following you. In a way, they remind me of the Super Mario jellyfish. I know, very, very fast stretch, but well. We were so close to getting that life. Okay, that's actually good. This room is good because one enemy is never a danger in this game. If he's alone, there's nothing he can do. Now, if there are two enemies on the screen, that is where the danger starts. Remember, he takes two hits, and as long as you know that, he is not that dangerous. But you need to make firm decisions of who you want to hit, because otherwise you try to hit two enemies simultaneously, and then you die, and... Ooh, that... is... You need to concentrate here for a moment. That is not such... I don't know if it looks easy, but it requires heavy concentration. So okay, what are we gonna do? I always go for health, but we can't afford it. Let's just increase our points then. Okay, this was the third stage, and I reached it, but I failed immediately. So let's try another run. Let's just try a last run in this episode and try to get to the third stage, you know, and actually do a room this time. Because, you know, each time I reach the third stage, I'm like, wow, did I just reach the third stage? And then I'm dead, and wow. And yeah, that is not how I should do that. Now, this, the fact that the bullets are attracted back to me, sometimes it can backfire, because sometimes I have a plan how to catch it, and I execute a superb jump, and then I'm just, wow, the bullet is in a completely different direction right now. Completely different place. Oh, we have still a life left. I have no idea why we did that. We are still going. This is the last run in this episode. And let's make the best out of it. We have 2 lives left. Why didn't I hit that? Yes, I did hit that. Okay, you go. And you, let's dodge that. And kill it from above. Okay. Oh, we have still 1 life left. I have not seen that. Okay, but now we're definitely dead. So, okay, guys, that is God Whale, and I definitely recommend it. I say, at least if you like what you see here, I will make a few more episodes out of it, maybe even a series if I like it. But what I definitely not recommend is playing this game 1 hour straight, because I tried it and it totally messed with my head. So yeah, if you enjoyed the episode, please press the like button, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.